Hello everybody, how's it going? My name is Cam and we're back in Red Dead Redemption 2. We are going to continue on. Do a couple of side missions. And then continue on with the main quest.
You Americans are nothing but shysters and traitors and slippery tongued bull suckers.
I'm inclined to agree.
Here, help me, please. Back to work, the bloody smile. No problem, Marco. You are the great genius, so we shall the hot poker up the ace. Say thank you, Marco.
Thank you.
What are you, some kind of European toy maker?
Oh. I am a fucking genius with poker up the ass, like I say. Oh,
well, it looked like I should entertain children.
No, he says. No. I am the savior of the mankind.
Yes, you meet him.
Professor Marco Dragic.
When the silver-tongued American betrayed.
Pay the money to him. Yes, he told the shit, man.
What's this toy about?
It is not a toy, Big Nuts. It is demonstration of my genius. My ideas about the source of life.
Oh, it's a toy boat.
Yes, it is a toy boat that I can power remotely using electricity in ways you cannot see.
Good for you. Ways I cannot see.
Still, the investors will not come. Ladies and immortal. Ladies! Gentlemen! Enchanté!
Hello! Hello, sir! Okay, how is the piles?
Yeah, good, good, good. Okay, my friends, you are about to witness history. A demonstration of my infinite insight.
All of us, we feel old. You are.
But maybe I can make you immortal. Using waves you cannot see, I will power this.
You're a goddamn fraud. And this buffoon dressed up like a buffoon is a stoolie.
I watch them conspire, you morons.
I never met this buffoon before 2 minutes ago. Isn't that right?
Which part of?
So, Professor, show us your magical toy boat. I mean, this time let the buffoon control. Check if there's any funny business.
No, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please. It is easy. Any moron could do it, and I am about to prove that. Here, take this, and this. Don't touch that.
Use these ones to steer and this one to shoot torpedoes, okay? Yes, now blow up the little battleships and avoid the sea mines. They have magnets attached, making nasty explosion if they touch the bottom.
What the heck?
If this silly dimwit can use torpedoes on board to destroy the battleships, imagine what technology can do in the hands of certified genius! And I have certificate. Mind now, look! See what he does? No wire like telegraph, no pulley system underwater. Only waves in the air.
This is remarkable. Think of those poor boys on the H.O. Hummer.
There, all gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now bring the boat back to the dock.
That sure was something, but I'm not sure what, if anything, was proven here.
Let me just reload.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess. The real miracles require investment.
Oh no.
Now the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of town, still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to, at least.
Shush! You're not here for this part, Paul. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires or coal or gasoline. No, just rays in the air. Like the voice of God.
And funding from us?
And funding from you, of course. But a thing to fund? What an opportunity! No one is stupid enough to pass this up.
No.
Not even
David. Come on.
Here.
Hey. You really want to work on your sales
mission? Americans! All you think about is sales!
Look who rules the seas!
Very good.
Very good!
Now bring in the boat back here. Foolproof! Undeniably foolproof! But you are not foolproof. As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
It is the stuff of life, sir.
It's incredible.
No. Incredible things are in my lab, back at Dover Hill. That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel. Can I count on your support?
No, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah, of course. And thank you. If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you. I hope you will forgive my...
That was kind of cool, honestly. Arthur, this horse is smaller than the one you had before, and you struggled getting on top of this one. Sorry. I like to keep it on me just in case.
Show. So don't come ask me.
I just don't like how much time you're spending with the man's arm.
just wait until you see his work. It's very progressive.
Well, I'm not so very sure how I feel about progression. Paintings otherwise.
You won't have seen like it before. I promise.
Maybe that's a good thing.
Just take all the cigars.
Hold on. Let me compose myself.
Is that me? That looks like... That is me. It's my hat, it's my jacket. How did they get a picture of me? No. Crap.
Look at these idiots.
Excuse me, Mr. Chatternay. Couldn't you have painted some drawers on her?
Madame, I paint her in her natural state, as she was and will be in paradise.
There's nothing natural about that.
Clothes are civilization, repression, death. To be naked is to be free, innocent, alive. Like Buddha said, you know, we are all just here to fuck.
Well, explains the decadence of those Hottentots.
Hey, you got a picture of my wife here, in her... Delicate!
Henry, is that your behind? To be shown it to that man!
That's my mom. As nude as the day she was born!
Stop looking at my husband's buttocks!
Stop looking at my mama!
Well, maybe she shouldn't expose herself like that!
This is disgusting!
The nerve on you!
That's it!
Oh, come on, Mildred! This is no place for us!
Come here! Hey. Bitch!
You filthy little man!
God dang! I'm gonna guess these guys don't have anything on them. Alright. God dang, I got messed up. And I'm all healed. God dang, that was fast. Okay, then. God, I wonder how much I'm gonna have to cut out of that. What the heck?
One moment, please.
Hey.
This is extremely delicate. Oh, wonderful. Algernon Wasp, purveyor of the exotic and the exquisite. Enchanté.
Tacitus Kilgore.
How can I help you? May I interest you in a hat, perhaps? How about a nymph? I import them from Brussels. The idiots in this town all want Italian nymphs, but the Italians make the coarsest of marble. I mean, quite frankly, the Baroque is an abomination. Belgium. Now that is a land for the connoisseur.
Oh, yes. As I always say. But, you know, not really a nymph kind of man.
No, of course, too ephemeral. You want something, more tangible, more gothic. I also make corsets. Would you like a corset? I always wear one.
Think so? Yeah, I ride a lot of horses. Whalebone might stick in.
A cup of tea.
Sure.
And what is it you do, Mr. Kilgore? Are you a gentleman of leisure? An aesthete? An artist?
Well, I suppose I'm kind of an adventurer.
Oh, yes, of course you are. Be careful with the china, sir. It is French.
Belgian?
No. They are Philistines in that area, not to be trusted. Youth, eternally preserved in marble is more their specialty. I fear China will always annoy them. Why are you here exactly?
I don't know.
An adventurer, a wanderer, a lost soul cast out from heaven?
Sure.
Well, I do pay exceptionally well for certain objects needed for my art.
You do?
I do. Exceptionally.
Well, what do you need?
Let's see. Right now, I have a couple of commissions. I need at least 15 egret plumes. Good ones, obviously. I also need 15 assorted orchids. Here's a list.
Okay. I'll see what I can do. Thanks for the tea.
Thank you, Tacitus. It'll be very worth your while.
I don't even know where to find all this. But okay then. See anybody? Oh my god, this city hates me.
Intervening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago. This will lead to war.
No, my son, not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Martin.
Yeah, it's Bad business.
It's to do with order. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal?
Obviously they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament. I'm a working man, I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is now done.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, an appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And booze.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The council wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.